Greetings, this Selective Princess.
I am Ja Prince, and this is the Sunsplash Mix Show. Princess.
We found Richie Stevens. Welcome to the show.
It's great to be here, man. Just getting outside the gym. That's why I'm not on in film. That's why the people are not seeing me. I just get out the gym, and you know that go already. But anyway, nevertheless, I'm glad to be on the program. I'm glad to be able to let the people know what's going on.
I like it. I like it. And just like you said, being outside, let's just quickly talk about that. In Jaja sun or the rain, in the yard, exercising. Richie, on your platforms, on your Facebook, people see that, yeah, man, you're really about that outside life.
Yes, you know, I appreciate the natural things in life. I appreciate nature. I appreciate life itself. So we do things to sustain life, because once you're in a good mental capacity and your health is all good, that is the ultimate happiness for me. I don't know about anyone else, you know. So I pay attention a lot to life itself, you know. And that is one of the reasons why I'm always out doing things in the sunlight. Yes.
And is it okay for us to just hit the like button when you're skipping rope or jogging or taking a walk, or do you want us to partake too?
No problem at all. No problem. The ultimate reason is to hopefully inspire some people, because I know a lot of people need inspiration, and some people need a little encouragement to just get on. You know, some people busy and can't find the time, but when they see someone else doing something that they always want to do, that may just encourage them to start. So the whole idea is to inspire people to, you know, get into healthy life.
All right, now to the music. We're thankful for your time, but the energy on this street gospel rhythm is explosive. Absolutely enjoy the rhythm.
So yes.
Tell us what inspired this production coming forth.
All right, so you see, I mentioned earlier about the appreciation for life and the appreciation for nature and all that. Those things, but those things, as we all know, coming from the Almighty, the Creator. And after being in the business for so many years, after being through such turbulence in my life, and still be here, still carrying on in music, I just decided to spend some time in just really sing some song and giving praise to the Almighty. So I've been doing that steadily for a number of years, but you might find that recently I've been doing that a lot.
Yes.
You know, it's for several reasons. I think our music need to reintroduce the presence of the Almighty, because we see what is happening now, where the Obeman is getting more praise than Jesus right now. Yeah, it's about the gathering and all those type of things for the youngsters. So whilst we can't tell people what to do or who to praise, we can still remind people that the Creator, the Almighty God, is still alive and well. So this is simply what we're doing through music. And what really inspired it, one day I was driving, and this melody starts playing in my head. So I called up my good brethren, Nitty Kutchy, because I always been producing songs with him over the years.
Yes, and I said and I to love him, them too.
Yes, I said to him, Kutchy, I have this awesome song. Them time is just an idea in my head, you know. It's not even recorded yet. I have this awesome idea that I'd love for you to sing. He said, Richie, you know, say anything, use them already. So I create the song, create the rhythm track, and then I call him in. I play it for him, because what I usually do when I'm doing when I'm creating a song for an artist, I sing it. So he was very excited today when he heard the song. And I said, but the only way this is going to really come off the right way is to have Buju Banton in this song. And he laughed. He said, well, that's not going to be easy still, but you don't know. We can try. Anyway, we said to him, and the Almighty, man, Almighty is Lord, man. No man no bigger than the Almighty. The whole we love the Almighty, and when him ordain something, people can hardly not do it. So him go check Buju. Buju hear the track, love the track, and recorded the track the same day.
Wow.
So that itself tells me that there was something special going on with this movement. And after Buju recorded the track, you know, we go check him and all the reasoning and him make me know some boy. I really himself him recording songs. So. Since him free up is really DJ Khalib alone, him record a track or two for. Me never really take that lightly. Me know say it's a tremendous anointing and blessing. And this whole track, why him do it?
Yeah, yeah.
So it was just Buju and Nitikochi on the song, and I was getting ready to put out the song. And then an idea just come to me about my song on it. Pray that away. And when I hear some people say there is no God, I just pray them away, you know. So I recorded that song and calling Kukudu, who is the other artist on it. So there was now two songs, two combinations.
Mm-hmm.
And as we go along, Killer hear the rhythm, love the rhythm. He said, boy, Killer, you know, so me have a weird idea in my head. And he said, what? He says to the youth of them, Kevin Downs, you're like, oh, artist that, I mean, know you rate him too, you know. Me I hear a song with you on him.
Oh, wow.
Killer said, Richie, make it happen. Me love that youth, make it happen. You know, so we call up Kevin Downs, well, tell him about the idea, I love it. Come in, record his part. We call Killer another day, put it together. Bam, explosion. Then Beanie Man here, the rhythm, love it. We come up with our vibes, record Beanie Man. So there are four songs now on the track. And it's going on really bad in the streets. Wow. Yeah, the people love it. The dancer love it. Let me tell you something. You see, in life, we need to understand that without leadership, we're nothing at all. And if we complain every day about things that's going wrong, and don't get up and try to do something right, then that explains why we're on such a downward spiral as it relates to our country, Jamaica, and our music, our Jamaican music.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people are say Afrobeat gone with the spotlight. People are say the music now sell again. People are say all kind of thing. But people not realizing, listen, if we're praising the devil in our music, you're not going to get no sunshine. And that is what I say, Aguan. That is just my thinking. This is just my opinion. I just think with the freedom of praising Satan in a dancehall music or reggae music, and a tabo gathering, and it's welcome. It appear. It people are dance when it appear. Me just think that I do a tremendous damage to we as a people.
Mentally, yes.
You understand? We have never gone that far. Dancehall has always been a music that have a bit of everything, including violence,
correct,
including hardcore sex, but we never prayed Satan yet.
Correct.
You know, so to me, we are get a serious beating where that is concerned. So again, I just feel like without saying nothing to no one, I tell nobody what to do, we just go to the studio and just do my little thing, which is to say the right thing in music, and not just by myself, but to get some of the most talented and some of the biggest voices, Buju Banton, Beanie Man, Bounty Killer, you know, all those youths, you know, because one thing's for sure, you know, people might, some Christian people, because I've seen a comment where somebody say, this is nothing more than just in pursuit of a hit song.
Mm.
And I smile. Mm. Yeah, I smile because we have to remember now, if there's power in the name of Jesus, to mention a name is a way to continue to keep the name alive.
Right.
Yes.
No, we've seen where, as I mentioned earlier, there's a lot of mention about Satan and a lot of mention about gathering and a lot of mention about the Obia man. So the Obia man and the gathering and Satan, if you don't mind sharp, will get more popular than Father God.
Right, right.
So anybody who willing to mention the name and to say the name of God Almighty, you have to welcome them.
Right.
So to me, there is just a confusion about some people that serve God and the views that they have about people who them feel secular. You know, we need to have an understanding about that. Most of the youth, them as hardcore as they may be, especially people from in my era, we hang on pan with God, we not let go, brother.
Yeah,
and God will say, you understand? And God will say. And, you know, when all is said and done, it is just a joy to see how the dancehall embrace the street gospel. and how them are run with it. I mean, Wednesday Ghana was at a session. Weddy.
Yes.
Stone Love. And the rain start fall. All of a sudden the rain just come down. And people start take time a walk away. So the selector realized that it mean a problem now, because there's nothing you can do to stop people from walking out of the rain. And me say, I was so frightened. The man said, people, that little rain, they will fall a blessing. Hear this and start playing the street gospel. Everybody turn back and start dancing.
Nice.
Which is right.
Everybody start dance. We say, wow, my head raised, man. I say, yeah, man, that's the power of God working. So, you know, it's about doing the right thing. Let's complain and just maintain. You understand me?
You said taking it to the street on the street gospel rhythm. Is it perceived as unconventional now? No, Richie Stevens, you're outside. You're really working the records. You're promoting it on social media. That should be the standard now. You believe in the project. You believe in it. You push it as a producer, so to speak.
All right. So let me tell you how me is a man, Steve, you know. You see, sometimes I forget some of my artists, you know. Sometimes we just do the normal things in life. I am a producer, singer, songwriter. I wear a few hats, right? And when I produce a rhythm, and I have people like Buju Banton and them and all these great people, me can't sleep in my bed at night and don't promote the same thing. Me have to go promote the song, because if you don't promote the song or the songs, may never live to see the full potential. We live in a time where the social space is everything. And if you don't find a way on it, if you don't go there, create content, which is to get the song played in the dance hall, the video man video it, you get clippings, you post it, all of them something there. You know, the internet is the biggest radio station now. So you have to go there and do the work. If you don't do the work, you might not get the result that you want. So I take off my artist cap and just go there and just really make sure everybody who play music have it. Make sure say the thing clear, make sure say everything I go on. And the artists them love that too. So when me call a man to come vice now, him no bother itching him, run come, because I know him song will be promoted.
To the fullest.
Yes.
And I can say from the streets, from the artists, from fellow producers, they do appreciate your professionalism and your guidance over the years. There's a reason why it's called Street Gospel Rhythm. You definitely are in the streets. You try and do the right thing and project the right thing to all.
Yes.
Now, The Flame is an artist that I've been following for quite a few years. I am ecstatic that she is on a track with Beanie Man, and it sounds wonderful. Will we see the video?
Watch this now. So Beanie Man basically hijack the track, because we're in a dance, we're in an Uptown Mondays and the rhythm play and pure excitement. And the next thing I hear is Beanie Man with the mic, take the mic from the selector and I say, yo Richie, me need for the pan a rhythm, and no. No, you know that's the doctor. Is that you to do him work? Is that you to deserve all the credit? You understand? So I said, don't worry yourself, man, everything good. And I remember now that Flame, I never met her before, but a lot of people tell me about her, and I listen to her material and realize she's a very exceptional talent.
Absolutely.
She's a very good singer. So when the whole Beanie Man thing hit me now, I said, well, here's an opportunity now to get this talented girl to come and sing on this track. So what I did was to just quickly put a song together and send it to her and say, please record it now and send it back. And that was my test to see how serious and how prepared she is. And in about an hour, she sent back everything.
Vocals
and everything. So I just want to say publicly how I appreciate her professionalism. She is ready for this. Because a lot of times you meet some artists where them not as quick are as interested as you'd like them to be. So when I meet people who have that same fire within them, I have to big them up. So big up the Flames and the song. Nice. People enjoy the song. People, I love it.
There you go. Everything happens at the right time. And the rhythm has been released. All digital streaming platforms. And again, like you said, maybe there's a video coming. Maybe there's a medley video. You know, Richie knows how to do medley.
You know, that is exactly what I'm thinking, to do a medley video, because there are five songs will be on it. Oh, I must tell you, the great Sanchez.
Don't say nothing else. Don't say nothing else. Yeah, just write this up.
Stop. Oh, added. But just recorded a song with Sanchez on there by himself. It's supposed to be a combination with someone else, but the other person I recorded it. But I'm just itching to put out Sanchez alone because I love the tune so much.
I like it. I like it. We're talking with Richie Stevens. Street Gospel Rhythm, now available everywhere. And just like he said, he just dropped a little teaser there. It might be number five, might be a medley video. Can we move on to Richie Stevens, the artist, the performer, and the father?
Yes, sir.
Because Father's Day is coming up. And Richie Stevens knows about the Family Fun Day here in Atlanta.
Yes, ma'am. We love Atlanta too, man. It's a great vibe. Let me big up Mikey Sparkle. It's Mikey Sparkle. He's a real human being, you know? Yeah, we're living in a time where a lot of things and a lot of people are fake. Mikey Sparkle is a real human being. Enough respect to the youth there. And I'm happy to return. The last time I was there was on his Christmas show. You remember that, Selector?
Yes.
Princess.
Yes.
That's that. Yes. You were there. Yes. And then I got a few offers in between, but I just hold it out and say, I want to go back on a Mikey Sparkle show.
Yeah.
So I'm glad that is the Father's Day event. And it's a very nice, it's what you call Less Is More. It's me and Mikey Spice, which Mikey Spice is one of my favorite artists.
Absolutely.
You understand? I mean, I love to sing with everybody, you know, because I have a lot of bridging in the music business and thing. But sometimes you just want a show that we can't get enough time to do a set. So the fact that it's only two of us, we'll get a chance to really perform for the people and do songs.
Correct.
From our catalog, you know. So I'm looking forward to it, man. I'm looking forward to it.
I like it. Sunday, June 18th. That's the Father's Day weekend. Just like you said, Mikey Sparkle presents. Princess, you know your lady other day too.
Julie Mango.
Yeah, man.
Yes.
Big up Chub Rock. And you know the music by The Big Clock, Steely Bashment, Mr. Memories. So it's a very diverse all-day Family Fun Day.
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's Father's Day, Sunday, June 18th, and it's from noon to 10 p.m.
Big up Mikey Sparkle. You know what it
is. Let me say, a lot of Mikeys will be at the show.
Yes.
Every father, Big Father Mikey, Uncle Mikey.
Yeah.
I know, man. I know, say, in respect all in the community, man. I know
very
that.
Much so. Exactly. Yeah.
No, yeah, he never was with the hypeness. No, just a nice guy.
Yeah.